Good morning, everyone. My name is B. Madhavi, lecturer in Mechanical Engineering, SRR of GPT, 6th year, subject code 18-MS-303, and subject name Thermodynamics. Today we have discussed that what is the bomb calorimeter, how to use the bomb calorimeter using, how to find out the high calorific value and low calorific value. In previous class, we studied about the what is the calorific value of air? What is the high calorific value? What is the low calorific value? What is the Douglas formula? What is the calorific value? Once again, repeat. The calorific value of air is the total quantity of air liberated by the complete combustion of the unit quality of the air. Is it clear? Then what is the calorific value of the quantity of the fuel is liberated by the complete combustion of the unit mass of fuel. Is that calorific value of solid and calorific value of gaseous fuel? The gaseous fuel is defined as the quantity of heat liberated by the complete combustion of the fuel per unit volume of the fuel at STP condition. What is the high calorific value? What is the low calorific value? So, higher calorific value or gross calorific value, the total amount of heat liberated when quantity of liquid fuel or gaseous fuel of fuel completely burned at the product of combustion or cooled at the initial temperature, that means at 15 degrees centigrade, that is a high calorific value. Low calorific value, net quantity of value is the amount of heat liberated by the a complete combustion of unit quantity of air without condensation of the steam, without condensation of the steam form, and the relationship between the LCV low calorific value and SCV low calorific value equal to higher calorific value minus MS into L kilojoule per kg. And what is the Douglas formula? High calorific value equal to 33,800 plus 144,000 into H2 minus O2 by 2 plus 9270S. Here CHO2 is a carbon, H2 is a hydrogen, O2 is oxygen, S is a sulfur. Is it clear? In previous class we discussed. Today class we discussed the combination of this. We will be able to know the description and procedure of determine the calorific value using of the bomb calorimeter. So purpose to find the high calorific value of solid and liquid of the fuels in bomb calorimeter using only solid and liquid fuels. So this is the figure. You see the what are the plots? Electrolytes and thermometer, stirrer, springer, and copper vessel, and air and water and crucible and iron rods and bomb and release valve and oxygen supply valve. This is a bomb calorimeter construction. So what is the construction? I clear explain that the bomb is made up. This pot is made of stainless steel. It is provided two valves. It's a release valve. Another one is the oxygen supply valve. Is it clear? One is a two valves. At top, it is the oxygen valve. And next one, oxygen valve is supply valve. And second one is the other product is release valve. The bomb immersed in a bath and water containing a copper calorimeter and water kept in a uniform temperature stirring. In this condition, this bomb is containing of two valves, one is oxygen supply valve, another release valve. This is a copper rods, iron copper calorimeter. In this is a iron rods, and in this one crucible. The total arrangement is dipped into the one water bath. The stirring in this. Steering of this steering stirrer means steer them maintain a uniform temperature. The bomb contains a platinum crucible. This is a platinum crucible. This hold the fuel and coil to ignite the fuel electrically. In this fuel is a crucible is there. We hold the fuel. In this fuel is burn. The coil will ignite them. Then fuel is completely burned. The calorimeter is surrounded by outer vessel, which is form of the air space of the calorimeter, and arrange the minimize the heat losses to the surroundings. So once again repeat. This is stainless steel. Bomb is made up of stainless steel containing up to two walls. One is oxygen supply valve, another is release valve. And oxygen supply valve, air is entered, release valve, and combustion is taken, unwanted valve, unwanted air gases are removing them. This is a carbon rod. This is a total bomb is dipped into the water bath. Water bathtub. In these two iron rods, the crucible is made of platinum. This crucible means hold the fire. Ignite the fuel electrically. This ignite the column is surrounded by outer resin, which is from the airspace to the calorimeter. The arrangement minimizes the heat losses to the surroundings. So it consists of a bomb made of stainless steel, which is made of high pressure. The top of the bomb provided two walls. One of the wall is supply, another wall is supply of oxygen or other release valve combustion to get the bomb provided with the crucible platinum. Make room and care to sample of fuel and coil ignite fuel electrically. The bomb is placed in copper vessel which is filled with the known quantity of the water. The system also provides the stirrer mechanism uniform distribution of the heat. We clear what is the as thermometer provides the measured temperature of the water. A copper vessel made of two layers such as air gap between the two between two layers. This is two layers are there. One layer copper is a air gap is there is an air gap. There is a surrounding of the there is a minimize the heat loss to the surroundings. Is it clear? What is the purpose of thermometer? Measuring the temperature. So thermometer means there is a maintain a uniform temperature. Still there. So what is the working principle of bomb thermometer? About 1 gram of coal. Approximately 1 gram of fuel is placed in crucible. The coil connected to the external circuit to the electrodes. You see that diagram is easily understand. About 1 gram of coal from a pellet of placed in a crucible. The coil is connected to the external circuit electrode. The oxygen supplied into the bomb. About 20 to 30 atmosphere. After the charging, the walls at the top of the bomb is carefully sealed. In this carefully sealed, and the bomb is placed on known mass of water contained in the calorimeter. In this surrounding water water known mass of there you know the mass of the water, and the temperature of water is measured with the thermometer chosen the study temperature. The coal sample ignited by closing of the electric circuit, and the stirrer operated maintain a uniform temperature. And during the experiment, the temperature reading recorded in the interval of minute until the maximum temperature attained. The bomb is removed from the calorimeter. The pressure release valve is open. That is removing of the combustion gases. The bomb is when the open, the crucible is inspected to the complete combustion, and the bomb is open, crucible is inspected to complete combustion. From a known volume of water equivalent to calorimeter, the calorimetric volume may be calculated the test result. So in this condition, once again repeat, 1 gram of fuel or liquid fuel or solid fuel taken into the crucible. In this condition, oxygen supply valve supply the air, and release valve is after complete combustion. There is a removing the combustion gases, unwanted gases. In this condition, electrical leads connected to the crucible rods. This electrical rods, the circuit is open. In this condition, the ignition rods ignite them, fuel is ignited. In this condition, we know the mass of the water. In this condition, if fuel is ignited, there is a thermometer heat surrounding thermo heat is transferred to outside. The condition is it is moved to the outside. There is a thermometer first initial condition. You measure the first you take the bomb. You crucible. There is no circuit. First condition you measure the thermometer temperature, room temperature. After igniting them, you measure the temperature in thermometer. You note that. Then after stirrer is using, you maintain a uniform temperature. Is it clear? Then a complete combustion is take out. There is a release valve is open and unwanted gases unwanted gases is passes through the release valve to outside the atmosphere. Is it clear? So in this condition, how to calculate the high calorific value? In this condition, first you take the mass of the fuel. I know capital M is a mass of the water and water equivalent water and initial temperature, final temperature, specific heat of water. All the data is there. You calculate the HCV. So how to calculate them? We go through this. Once again, repeat. A weight quantity of fuel is placed in a crucible. The oxygen is supplied to the oxygen valve until the pressure inside the bomb calorimeter increases 25 to 30 atmosphere. The bomb is immersed to measure mass of water in calorimeter. The sample fuel is ignited through the ignition rod, the means of electric current. The stirrer is maintaining a uniform temperature of water in the calorimeter. The readings of the thermometer recorded every half minute and until the temperature reaches the maximum value. After the temperature shall start going down, and then the bomb is removed from the water. The pressure releases valve opened, the reducing the pressure inside the bomb. The bomb is opened, confirm complete combustion of the fuel. So working from the higher calorific value can be found as a follows. Let M cap, small m is a mass of fuel is burnt in kg. Capital M is a mass of water in calorimeter kg. MC, water equivalent of calorimeter in kg. T1, initial temperature of water. T2, final temperature of water. CW, specific heat of water. That is a 4.18 taken as a 4.2 kilojoule per kg. HCV, high calorific value. Assuming no heat losses, heat liberated by burning fuel equal to heat absorbed by water in calorimeter. First, heat liberated by the fuel, burning fuel equal M into HCV. M is a mass of fuel, HCV is a high calorific value. Here, capital M, capital MC is into CT2 minus T1. Capital M is a mass of water, and CW is a specific heat of water. And T2 is the final temperature of the water. And T1 is the initial temperature of the water by M. So we can calculate the HCV, capital M plus MC, CW T2 minus T1 by M. There is a HCV value. The concentration of the heat liberated by the fuels were the cooling correction as a TC. The above equation written as M into CV plus MW into CV, that is M capital M plus MC in CW T2 minus T1 plus TC. MW is a mass of fuels were, CV is a calorific value of fuels were, TC is a cooling reaction. So, once I get repeat. What is the bomb calorimeter? How to working principle of the bomb calorimeter? And what is the main purpose of bomb calorimeter? In this working principle of high, in this bomb calorimeter using of the solid fuel, liquid fuel, high calorific value is find out them. So bomb calorimeter is a, which is a diagram to find out the HCV, high calorific value of solid and liquid of the fuels, and it is a diagram. There is a bomb, there is a platinum stainless steel connecting up two walls are there. I top oxygen wall, there is supply wall, oxygen wall is oxygen supply wall. In this condition, supply of the oxygen, and there is a release valve. After compunction is complete take place, then unwanted gases are removed from the release valve. There is a two iron rods are there, ignition rods are there. These hold the crucible, platinum crucible is there. This crucible has hold the fuels, and this crucible connecting with the ignition rods. There is electrical leads are there in this condition. So this bomb is kept in a water bath. This water bath is connected completely with copper vessel. In this, some air gap is there. There is a heat loss to the surrounding. Some is there. There is air gap is there. In this, thermometer is main purpose measure the temperature. The stirrer more with the water. There is a water stirring there. In this conditions, maintain a uniform temperature. So first, in this condition, known quantity of the fuel is taken into the crucible. In this condition, oxygen supply valve is open. Oxygen supply valve is open. An oxygen supply through the bomb calorimeter, and there is a electrical lens. There is a fuel. In this condition, first. In this condition, bomb calorimeter, known quantity of the water is water mass is measuring them. And next, in this thermometer, first initial temperature measuring them in thermometer. Yes, electrical leads are using to when circuit is. The cold sample is lit by the closing of the electrical leads and electrical circuit. The coal and fuel is burned there. The stirrer is operated by maintaining uniform temperature during the temperature. And the temperature reading record the interval of 30 seconds until the maximum temperature attained. In this condition, first complete fuel is burned. There is a temperature increases. You measure the thermometer in half minute, 30 seconds. Stirrer is stirring them, they maintain a uniform temperature. In this condition, you find out the high calorie equal, heat liberated by the fuel equal to, and heat absorbed by the water and calorimeter. In this condition, there is a coal is burned them. There is a coal is burned, some amount of heat is generated. The heat is absorbing of the water. There is some amount of water is heated and absorbing the water in calorimeter. Then equal the here. So electrical leads and thermometer stirrer spinning. In this condition, bomb is there, ignition rods are there, the crucible there, hold the crucible in fuel. Then oxygen supply was about 25-30 atmospheric pressure. The valve is open, the oxygen supply then in the crucible in platinum coal is holding them. Electrical circuit is closed condition. Coal is ignited then. In this coal ignited, then complete combustion take place. The initial condition thermometer temperature is measured then. There is a after complete combustion is take place, then you measure the temperature in thermometer. Stirring them of the water. They maintain uniform temperature until attain the maximum temperature. Is it clear? In this condition, you find out the HCV is called heat absorbed, heat liberated by the fuel equal to heat absorbed by the water and calorimeter. Is it clear? So we get the formula. HCV equal to m + n + Cw(T2 - T1)/m. The working rate, the constant heat liberated by the fuse wire and cooling correction above the equation can be written as m into HCV + m + Cw (T2 - T1)/Tc. MW is a mass of fuse wire, Cv is a calorific value of the fuse, Tc is a cooling correction. So in this description of working principle of bomb calorimeter offer finding of the high calorific value in solid liquid fuels. The approximate pressure maintained temperature is 25 bar. The bomb calorimeter using for find out the Cv of is liquid fuel, solid fuel, gas, solid and liquid fuel. Explain the working principle of calorimeter.